Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.
This holiday season, fill the search station that will make you want to go out and give a donation. By clicking the link in the description below, you can help make a child's wish come true.
With the real world.
Welcome to my channel. It's Serge bringing you another action figure collector's review on the My Hero Academia's Izuku Midoriya. He's in his full cowl. This is a GameStop exclusive. Up here, you get two fisted hands. You get a little stand for him to stand on. You get Izuku Midoriya right here in the side from the show. You get his name right beside of it. Over here on this side, you get his name. You get Funimation and you get McFarlane Toys. On the other side, you get My Hero Academia right there. Funimation at the bottom, McFarlane Toys at the top. You get the figures from this wave. And over here at the top, you get a nice image of Class 1A. And down here at the bottom, nothing but the barcode. Let's get to it and open this bad boy up.
Take a good look at his accessories. You don't get really a whole lot of accessories with these figures. But right here, you get two fisted hands. Right here, you get this little full cowl effect going on his hands, which looks really good. They did good job on that. Panaps is really good on it. There, I got a little bit of chipping going on right there. There's some seams in his gloves going through there. The sculpt work's nice. I really enjoy the sculpt work on these figures. They look really, really good. Right here, let's get a look at the other one. I love the pink on the hands. That looks nice. Right there. And then you got a little bit of, I guess, extra paint right there. The sculpt work looks good. The hands look great. Very pleased with that. Here's his two open hands. It's nice. I like the way his hands is kind of grasping. I got a little bit of extra pink right there. It's like you can use your imagination and be like, oh, it's like glowing, you know. But right here, that pink looks good. I'm satisfied with that. Gloves look good. The sculpt work's nice. Right here, look at the other glove, looks good. It's where you put the peg. That pink looks good going all the way up that middle finger there. Looks really, really good. I'm pleased. And here's his little stand he can stand on. Every of the My Hero Academia figures, they get one of these stands to stand on. You don't really need them with these figures, but sometimes they like to fall over. It helps. So, let's get a look at the
Midoriya figure. Out of the box, and here he is, fully charged and ready to Detroit smash. Midoriya standing next to himself. And the full cow one, as you can see, is a repaint of this one. They did a really good job with the effect, I think. There are some differences, and let's go ahead and take a look at them. As you can tell, this one has green and black in his hair, which looks good. And this one is just like a straight green color. I wish we could have got like more of a watch or something, but it doesn't look bad. I'm still satisfied with the figure. And right here, this little effect piece that goes around his arms and wrist right here. It's kind of, this one's lighter than this one, but you can't really tell it on camera. But this one is just a slightly bit darker. It could be because of the figure or something, but I just see it as being a little darker. Now, let's go ahead and look at the figure. Look at the paint apps right here. It's very clean. Oh, and one thing I forgot to mention with this one. He came with an extra face sculpt right here. More of a happy Midoriya face. And the GameStop exclusive one didn't come with that. So, it would have been nice to get an extra face, but I mean, he's full cowed, so he's not going to be happy in full cow. And another thing I would like to say is you can remove the hair off of this one to swap out the face. And I was trying to with this one, but I was scared I was going to break my figure. So let me know in the comments below to see if you can actually remove that. But anyway, let's get to it and look at the figure. I think they did a really good job on him. The paint apps for the most part look really clean on this one. It's the cleanest I've seen on any of these McFarlane My Hero Academia toys, or figures I should say. But they didn't do no full cowling effect on his back, which is a little disappointing, but you're not going to really have him pose like that anyway on your shelf. You're going to have him facing you or battling, you know, Tomura's Shigaraki. But yeah, it looks good. And this right here is poseable, so you can put it around any finger or wrap it around his hand. It doesn't really matter, however you prefer to pose it. I'm probably just going to leave it like that for right now. Let's take a look at his articulation. His head can move that far up and a little bit further down. That joint's really, really stiff. His arm can rotate and do a full 360. Now this arm, I was moving it around and it just fell off on me, so be careful with that, but it popped right back into place. So I just figured I'd let you know. He's got a double jointed elbow that moves in that far. He's got a swivel up here at his upper arm. And he don't have one right here at his wrist, but he has his wrist can turn around a full 360. It's got that ball hinge, so you have to be careful with that. Trying to figure out where that where you can bend it at. It feels like it's going to be a little stiff. There we go. Goes that far back and that far in. And you can rotate that ball joint around in there. And you can turn his hand side to side, which is nice. I like that. His diaphragm can go not too far forward. A little bit further back. And he can lean that far to that side and that far to this side, and he's got splits that can go out pretty far. He can kick forward that far, just a little bit, and back not so much. He's got a he don't have a cut up there at his thigh, but he's got a cut right here at his ankle, so you can turn that ankle left or right. He's got toe articulation. You can bend his foot. Well, you can't bend it up or back, no. But he does have like an ankle pivot effect right there. So that's pretty nice. I like that. And on this one right here, over a little bit of time, like if I raise it up that far, his arm just pops right on out. So that's, I was just wanting to let y'all know. It's the same thing with this one. I lifted his arm up a little bit and see, it just pops right on out. Anyway, that's a good look at his articulation. He can tilt his head that far to the side and that far to the other side, and it can rotate and round and do a full 360. Now, it felt like it wanted to pop off on me, but it's okay. See, it's still in there real good, so don't worry about that if you feel your figure's head wanting to pop off while you're trying to spin his head around. And let's get a better look at that sculpt work. Let's take a look at all the wrinkles and stuff that's in his uniform right here. Looks good right here at the thighs. I like how it wrinkles up and stuff. And I like his pouches and his belt. I think that looks really, really good right there. I mean, let's take a better look at that right there. Look at that. It's got sculpt work right there, divided up. I wish we could have like got a little bit of like a dirt look to it, like, you know, like dirty wash, but just some dry brushing or something. But it's okay. I'm not complaining too much with it. Right here at the legs and the shin guards, I really do enjoy that. I like the black and the pinkish, purplish looking color for the cap full cow effect. I think that looks good. His boots look really, really good. I enjoy that. And he's got a little bit of red, extra red right there. But he could have been beating up some bad guys and got some blood on his shoe. You know what I'm saying? So that's not too bad. And right here at the butt, he's got a seam going down his crack. Let you know where his butt cheeks separate at. And right here, he's got some nice little wrinkles back there. I like that. Right here is hood. I like that. Or his mask, or whatever you would prefer to call that. Looks nice. He's got some wrinkling right going on right in there. It's nice, real nice, clean paint apps on this one, very clean. And right there, around there, that looks good. I don't know what you would call that, is to cover his face. So I guess this part would be like a mask part. And this part would be like the hood that covers his head. And then, yeah, his arms and stuff looks nice. You can really take this off, too. It unpegs. So let's go ahead and wrap that off real quick so we can get a better look at them arms. It looks nice. The wrinkles, the detail. McFarlane Toys really does a good job with their detail on their figures, I believe, for my opinion. But, yeah, that's a good look at the sculpt work. Midoriya scales with his mentor. You have All Might. Both of them. The GameStop exclusive one, which I just did a review on. If you want to go check it out, you can do so. And then you have the regular All Might. Now, I like the way they scaled with one another. Midoriya's supposed to be shorter because he's supposed to be a teenage boy. And then All Might's this big, beefy man. So, I like the Midoriya scales with Bakugo on the left and Tomura Shigaraki on the right. Now, I like this scaling too. Shigaraki's supposed to be a little bit taller, and Bakugo's supposed to be about the same height as Midoriya, so this is a really good scale. Now, Midoriya scales with a couple of Power Rangers from the Lightning Collection. You have the Beast Morphers Gold Ranger on the right, and the Dragon Shield Black Power Ranger on the left. I already did a review on both of those Power Rangers. If you want to go check them out, you can do so. Just for fun, here's how he scales with a couple of Marvel Legends symbiotes. You have Carnage on the right and Back in Black's Deadpool on the left. My final thoughts on this figure. I really like this figure. I think it's an upgrade to the one that was previously released. I think it was a little bit too soon to get a repaint of this figure this early on in this line. Let me know what you think of the figure. Let me know what you think of the review in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content from me. As always, feel the urge to collect with Surge. Forget about your chance to win this Marvel Legends New Mutants Danny Moonstar. All you have to do is follow me over there on social media. Links are going to be in the description below. You can hit like, comment, and subscribe to this channel. Also, you gotta make a donation to Toys for Tots. Links to that is going to be in the description below. Contest ends December the 22nd, 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Thank you all for watching this video, and good luck. Never meant to make your daughter cry. I apologize to children. Yeah. I got your DNA all over me.